elementary school teacher. Except for I fucking hate kids. No. Let's see. We need a dangerous activity for these two guys. And we sometimes like zip lining, rock climbing, skydiving, but something like a little unusual. Take a second. What's like a fun activity that's got some like, you know. Downhill running. Whoa. You're gonna kill him.
He looked one look at me and was like, that fucker can't run down a hill.
I just picture you like crumbling. I love that. Okay, guys, let's get started with a round of applause.
Oh, shit, that's deep.
Reverse!
Oh, deep, that shit. Oh, shit, that's deep.
Yeah. Let's go.
What?
Reverse!
What?
Go, let's.
Forward!
Let's go.
What? All right. Heidi and John, can I please have a movie genre like horror or sci-fi?
Historical fiction.
I
love that.
Left. Now we have Heidi and John. For Heidi and John, can I please have a relationship like a butcher and his customer, or the librarian and the noisy kid?
John and the prostitute.
John and his prostitute. All right.
John and his prostitute.
Left.
Not John.
Hey, John.
Ah, now, for Bree and Sean, what I need is a fictional world.
The Matrix.
Left. And for John and Bree, can I please have a decade? Now, four of you left. They're going to go ahead and repeat the genres.
Historical fiction.
Left.
A John and his prostitute.
Left.
The Matrix.
Left.
The
1980s.
And left. Ladies and gentlemen, can we please get these teams started with a round of applause?
Believe you've been so forward in your attention to me.
Of course I'm being forward. I'm the first president of the United States.
I no, Mr. Washington.
That's President Washington.
President Washington, your hair is something to be admired, but I'm just confused as to what a president does. This is all so new to my fine feminine.
Abigail, I didn't come here to talk about work. I came here to talk about your sweet, sweet honey you've been making in the fields. I came here to tell you that I'm also an alien.
Left!
$10, baby, that's all you need.
$10?
Yeah.
$10 for you, honey, I am afraid. $10 for you is gonna mean $150 down at the clinic to fix whatever you put on my Johnson.
Oh, I feel so disrespected.
I am so sorry to disrespect you, who are a fine sex worker in this economy. I understand.
I never said I was fine. I'm $10.
Left.
Neo, you are the only one who can save.
Oh, I'm going to shoot you by mistake.
Oh, no. Don't shoot me.
I'm becoming an agent.
I'll stop you with my slow motion moves.
Oh, Danielson.
Yes, Mr. Miyagi.
Danielson, you cannot lose your temper while I'm doing homework.
But the homework is so stupid.
Danielson.
I hate spelling.
3 helicopter kicks.
Oh. Yeah.
Yes.
Yeah.
Yes.
Yeah.
Yes.
But I am so small, and the boys make fun of me.
Yes, I saw them making fun of you. They may said you had a tight butt.
Yeah. They said.
Mr. President, I fear your lady-in-waiting has seen you without the wig and has guessed your secret, that you are, in fact, an alien.
And I just told you.
Well, I
mean, I feel like you've known this whole time.
It feels like I've known you for months and months now instead of just the moments ago you told me you were an alien.
Oh, that feels good. Oh, yeah. I like to see with my temple.
Left!
Is this what you paid for?
Well, you know, if you're going to clean it that way, that is fine. I really feel it's sanitizing. Oh, wait.
Left!
Neo, they're here! They're going to kill us!
No, they won't. They're not stopping us today. Here, eat one of these pills.
The red one?
Left!
Son.
Yes. Yes!
If Elizabeth Shue doesn't date me, no one will.
That's why you must beat up her boyfriend in the state championship.
Left!
Your third eye is so shiny and beautiful, and I feel I'm falling for you all over.
I cannot tell a lie. I have fallen for you too.
Left!
Oh, baby, you are the best $10 whore I have ever bought with my money.
Left!
Kill everyone! They're all in part of the nation!
Rip! Be Johnny. It wasn't Mr. Miyagi at all.
Bunzai!
That's right. You gonna try and take my girl?
I'm gonna try to take your woman!
Left!
Where shall we go? Will we live on this earth forever, or shall we go to your home planet?
Left!
Whoa, 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 whoa!
Bow, bow, chicken, to
left!
Left!
Left! Left!
Take me away!
Oh, this is just a weekend!
Left! Yes, how you do it?
Some weird ways. So our next game is going to be called John Repeat, and I need Bree and John on stage right now. Let's give them a warm welcome. Warm welcome. Last one. So the way this game works is our two actors are going to be doing a mundane scene inside of the house. So I need something that they would be doing inside of a house. Sweeping. Okay, cleaning, sweeping. So you guys.
Any particular room?
Any room in the house.
Bedroom.
Bedroom.
Those hardwood floors.
And let's get started with a round of applause.
Come on, Devon.
You see, you put up our family picture.
I know, right? Well, it was after they kicked us out of Epcot Center.
Oh, yeah. Drink all around the world. That's what happens.
You know what? That was a pretty amazing vacation, honestly. Even if Ronnie lost 2 teeth and his diggity.
Rachel?
Remember your shirt from Epcot?
Oh my god!
Oh boy! Oh, oh, I love you, Rachel!
Sweetheart, that's so sweet. I forgot that you got that for me. You know what? I have a little something for you. It's not Disney related.
Oh, well, fucking keep it. Just kidding. I'm just kidding. Sorry.
Whoa. Why are you swearing at me? You don't want anything if it's not Disney related? Is that it?
I love Disney. It's because I grew up on the mouse, and then, you know, I just saw a Goofy movie again.
All right, well,
I'll take it.
No,
I was just you always tell me to get my emotional reactions out there. Then when I do, I get crucified for it. Whoa.
Nickelodeon,
you son of a bitch. Nickelodeon, honey? Nickelodeon?
I'm assuming you're going to hit the t-shirt and not me.
Yeah, of course I'm not going to hit you. What kind of husband is the guy?
Ha! And scene! All right, so that was a great scene. That was a great scene, but we want to challenge them a little bit. We want to switch it up. So I need a kind of genre that they can do that same exact scene again. We got stuff like space western, horror, something fun that you would see on TV.
Film noir.
Film noir. Okay. All right, we're going to do a film noir. All
right, cool. Thank you, Eddie.
Dame had legs. Legs for days. I didn't expect her to clean. I assume she liked it.
He was my own private dick at home. I loved having him in the bedroom, even though he didn't know what to do around it.
Good sweeping on the floor, babe.
Yeah, that's right, honey. You see that picture of my family?
Ah, that's a good picture.
The family I'm betraying by being here with you.
That's the family she's portraying. Little does she know. I hook up with him too. But that's another story.
He didn't think I knew about his hookup with my husband, but I knew, and I was into cuckold.
Oh, Epcot, that was a good time. Going all around the world. Hey, that reminds me, a gift I got you from there.
Oh, I like gifts. I like anything that I can put in my pocket.
Aha!
Oh boy! Uh-huh.
That's the voice of a mouse. His name's Mickey. He makes a lot of money.
Well, that's real sweet of you. I got you a present too.
Oh, is it?
Oh yeah, it's in that drawer over there. And by drawer, I meant a square box.
Whoa! Easy there, Dane. Last time she got me a gift, it was a gun or is it an STD? What's it gonna be?
You gotta find out.
I guess I'll wait then. Slowly, honey. Slow, no.
It's an STD!
Rugrats, you son of a bitch! Rugrats were my arch nemesis ever since I was a small boy. They were also small children in the movie. You know I hate Rugrats and Chucky. He's always afraid of everything.
That's right, honey. Case is closed.
Fancy! Oh, that was awesome. That was awesome. Very intense. All right, we're going to try this one more time, and now we need another fun genre that they're going to play with. Musical. Musical, right? Set it. It's musical. Okay. Can we get started with a round of applause, please?
Sleep, it's fun, sort of.
I love holding the dustbin for my honey bun. Sweeping fun,
sort of. Oh, honey dear, I love you so. When I put my stuff in your bin.
In my bin,
don't you know that we will always be life partners?
I see there's a picture of our family, of our offspring, when we did the thing with our things.
My family, when our son lost his teeth at Epcot. Damn that place in Florida.
Tallahassee,
Florida.
buttons off and we get to work.
Let's do it.
And see. Stay tuned next time to see what happens after that.
Awesome, guys. Next up, we need Sean, Matt, and Deshaun. Is Deshaun here? Guys, we are going to be playing a game where these gentlemen are going to be doing three different scenes. And the only rule is they have to, all three of them have to die in each of the scenes. So we need to start off three locations. What's a fun location to go on a date to? Not a restaurant, somewhere an activity. What's a fun activity to go?
Axe throwing.
Axe throwing. What? Sorry, what was that?
Karaoke.
Oh, okay. Let's first do axe throwing, which I love. So the first one is an axe throwing bar.
The bar.
Yeah, axe throwing bar.
I wonder what's going down.
How will they die? Awesome. The second location will be a karaoke bar. Sound good? And then we need a third location, something totally unrelated, some kind of maybe like a professional kind of situation. I heard a gynecologist. I did hear it. Do what you want with that. A gynecologist.
Okay, I heard something. Wait a minute.
Okay. Awesome. So just to revisit, we're going to be at an axe throwing bar, we're going to be at a karaoke joint, and we're going to be at a gyno's office. Awesome. Guys, can we start off with a round of applause?
Hey, shots on me.
Right on, axes on me.
I really shouldn't be drinking on the job, but all right.
Hey, tip your bartenders here at Axe.
I told you this guy was
cool.
No, please do not stop throwing the axes in the air, please, sir.
I thought it was an axe place.
Yeah. We have targets. The targets are over there. That's where you throw. You don't just throw them willy nilly into the air, right?
Switch to the karaoke joint.
And the time of my life. And I never felt this way before. Yes, I swear it's the truth. That I've been cheating on you with this black guy. I'm sorry!
Whoa!
Why? Hey, I had to tell him!
Dave, why would you invite both of us out here to karaoke to tell him now?
I have to express my emotions through song. You both know that.
Switch to the guy to office!
Wanna sit down?
This is my first time here.
I can tell. I can always tell the first time. Plump, scared, unsure.
Oh my god.
Just your baby kicking.
Oh.
Oh no.
It's kicking. Sorry, I was startled.
That's why I knew you were a first timer. I can tell that. I even heard it. I can hear the babies. I'm good. Oh, wow.
He's gonna be a boxer.
A boxer? Well, let's just see what he has to say. Fly like a butterfly?
Sting like a bee.
He's gonna be a boxer. He's gonna be a good one.
Switch to the axe place!
Alright, I think my best 7 out of 7.
Okay. Going for the.
Alright, just.
Yeah, just go ahead and throw that.
Going for the king.
Dude! Come on, I was gonna throw it at the bartender!
Karaoke bar!
Alright, now you both know.
I mean, I already knew.
I didn't know.
You already knew.
Well, yeah, I mean.
Yeah, you've been sleeping with him.
Back to the X Star.
Oh man, so who won?
I'm so glad we're the only ones here.
Gyno office.
Oh
no.
Oh, he's.
You're having a contraction.
I am.
All right, hold on. I have to induce labor. Hold on.
Right here.
Yep. Yes.
I thought this was just a checkup.
No. Supposed to be for you.
And I'm gone! And the year is 45 years later. My parent has died of natural causes and I'm still alive.
Back to the karaoke bar!
I can't believe you.
What? Oh, no! Wait, no! 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 Please! Please! No! Daddy!
I can't.
All right.
Whoa!
Well, you're up!
Hey!
Your turn. I find you You go. Oh shit! Oh shit! Oh no! Oh no!
Karaoke bar!
You son of a bitch!
I'm the son of a bitch! You were sleeping with him!
Yeah, and I loved him! And now, I'll love you!
I feel like I can't say no.
Of course. Here. Let's take one shot. Do you remember this moment?
I'm
sorry. Oh, no! Oh, man!
Goodbye, cruel world. I join you both, my lovers.
Is that the L train?
Your mother-in-law.
Horrible. Aggravating.
Horrible? Okay, I have a good mother-in-law, by the way. Horrible. And then what's a holiday that no one celebrates but should?
Martin Luther King Day.
All right, guys, this story is going to be called... I don't even know what to say. All right, this is going to be called...
2021! Look it up!
The horrible giraffe has a good Martin Luther King Day.
Once upon a time, there was a giraffe named Stephen. He was horrible. He used to stomp on the smaller animals in the jungle.
And all the small animals were tired of the giraffe's shit. They said, we got to stand up to this giraffe. We can't let him walk all over us with his long neck and his long legs. So all the squirrels and bunny rabbits got around and they decided to place some nuts all around where the giraffe eats. And when the giraffe starts eating, the squirrels are gonna make their way to the nuts as bait. And when the giraffe plans to-
It's gonna step on a Brazil nut and flip over like his long dumbass legs should. And while he's flailing in the air, Queen Mouse of Nebulon is gonna come out and tell the giraffe what they need to hear. Let the small rodents have a dream.
And that dream is that someday giraffes and mouses won't have to fight anymore. They'll be able to live life together in harmony without walnuts or other kinds of nuts on the ground to make them cry.
And nuts in the trees. And the Queen Mouse of Nebulon said, Giraffe, we must learn to live together because we are one in this world and have to depend.
And we are brown giraffes and yellow giraffes and gray squirrels and small rodents.
Sorry, keep going.
And we have a dream to live in this world peacefully, where we're not stepped on or shit on from high butts from long legs. And Queen Nebula said, yes, this is the dream. This is the dream that we will all dream together.
I think that white guy has a point. Keep going.
And I am so topical. I am so
And the giraffe was listening very intently. And said, you know what? You're right, Queen. You're right. And then 40 years later, it was still happening. There were giraffes still stomping on all the rodents. So other people showed up and said, we gotta shut these giraffes up. Jesus Christ, why are all these giraffes so stupid?
The activist squirrels came out and said, no more giraffes. stepping on us. We really want that to stop right now. And
this time around for the protest, there were other giraffes with the rodents. They were woke giraffes. They were with it, okay? And they did a little march, and they marched up to Mr. Giraffe's house. He's in his 80s now, but he still has clout.
Okay. And then the giraffe opened the door, and he looked out among the animal kingdom. And he looked out, and he said, I'm sorry. I just didn't see you down there. I know you see me as tall, and I see me as tall, and I was kind of an asshole back there. In fact, I was probably a real asshole for stepping on you.
I'm pretty sure I'm an asshole because that's the way my parents raised me to be. So I didn't know any better, and I thank you for coming and educating me.
Yeah, it's my parents' fault. It's not mine.
So, everyone, follow me. We're going to go to my parents' house. So they all started walking down to Mr. and Mrs. Giraffe's house. That's in the land.
Mr. and Mrs. Giraffe are way too old for this shit. They don't even remember the original dream speech. Yeah. They weren't there. They weren't watching. They were watching Golden Girls. It was a wet riot, yes.
And for the Germans, So old mom giraffe and daddy giraffe said, we won't stand for this, all of this activist bullshit. And then all the little rodents started to burn their house down. They said, fuck these boomers, fuck them. Tired of all these boomer giraffes. They need to get out of here, it's a new year.
And those spotted bastards trickled down to the ground. All right, inside of their white marble mansions. And all the little giraffes that were woke.
There were some woke giraffes.
And all the rodents came jumping on the ashes and said, on this spot, we're gonna build a fucking monument.
That's right, and all the rodents except the fox, because they watch their own news network there. So that's right.
So there's two different realities.
And while everybody else was distracted, the fox was sitting in his little news station, getting all the other foxes really into some bullshit.
Okay. Yeah, and then they were like talking about conspiracy theories, like the aliens coming down. God, those aliens. And then the sun started to set, and someone noticed that Jupiter and Saturn were about to kiss up in the sky.
And there was a lone mouse who said, what in the fuck is all this about?
And that mouse's name was Hillary Rodham Clinton. Confused and alone, wondering how the fuck this happened.
With kids. I've been talking to friends of mine and they say the same thing happens with them.
Oh, good, Mom. See, it's okay if I trash things. I'm young.
No, it's not okay to trash my things.
But Mom, would it be okay if I wore your belt sometime?
If you borrowed them respectfully, it'd be all right.
Thin little snakes that you put on your body. Wrap them around your waist. Hold your pants high. Little snakes around your waist make you pretty. Make you so thin, you don't want to die. I love belts. I love them. From one
I shit and you trash it like that, but I love you, Jennifer, I love you. Even when you borrow the car without asking where my belt
is, I love
everything you're doing.
They're so awesome,
Jennifer.
And I put on the right below my bosom.
Even when you dance on the lawn and embarrass me with my neighbors, I still
my
love
mom.
You.
They don't care my underwear.
I love you.
Thanks, Mom.
Have fun.
Thank you. Next up, we are going to do a dating game. Who's feeling saucy in the new year? Johnny, you want to host?
Oh, absolutely. All right, Fran. So this dating game here, taking place here in Savannah, Georgia. First, let's go ahead and bring up our contestant. Our contestant has a fictional name. You guys are going to name right now. What's the first name you wanted to have?
Chucky.
What was that?
Daniel.
Daniel Chucky. Ladies and gentlemen, put your hands together for Daniel Chucky. Sir. Come on up. Yeah, Daniel Chucky.
I just get a little nervous.
No worries. This is your night, Daniel Chucky. Daniel Woo! Chucky, I know you're a local here in Savannah. What do you do?
Oh, I teach fish.
Like, what?
I teach the fish.
You teach the fish?
Somebody has to.
Okay. What do you teach the fish?
All the basics. Upstream, downstream.
Do you have like a school?
I have a school of schools.
All right, moving on.
You up for grabs?
How are you still available? All right. So we got three contestants coming out tonight. They have some specialty experts. Our first contestant, you guys know the expertise. Like last week, we had someone that was an expertise in Lamborghinis. We had someone that was an expertise in Star Trek. We had someone that was an expertise in hamster shit. So take a moment here. Remember what the expertise is. What's the first expertise of our contestant?
Dildos.
All right, we're going there. Okay, you got it. All right, the first expertise here is dildos. Get around. All right.
Well, that's on brand.
All right, contestant number two. So we're going to try and move away from those bottle of dildos, my friends. What's moving away? What's another expertise that's not in the same world as dildos?
Accountant.
All right, give it up for the accountant. All right. Our last contestant here. We have dildos. We have accountant. All right. What's the expertise of our last contestant? What was that?
Puppies.
All right. Here we go, Mr. Chucky. Daniel. I'm gonna give the contestants an opportunity to say their name and their expertise and a little bit about their expertise. Not too long, just a quick first opening pitch.
I appreciate that. Thank you.
All right, contestant number one, go ahead.
I'm Danny Dildo.
So can you tell us a little about your expertise?
Oh yes, sorry, I got a lot going on in my head right now. So I'm an expert on dildos. I ran my own factory and I just
You run a dildo factory?
Yes. It's been my lifelong dream.
All right, okay. Fantastic. Contestant number two.
I know what I'm getting for Christmas.
I'm Lewis Carroll with an accountant. I make sure that the numbers are right for certain organizations. Not naming names.
I'm scared.
Compelling.
Add me up.
My name is Max. Max, I'm a good dog. I'm an expert in puppies.
Okay. I feel like that's illegal in most states. I'm up for it.
Not in Georgia.
Not here. Right. Not in Savannah.
All right. So I know you have a question for our possible contestants. What's your first question for us?
All right. I love spontaneity. Of course. Like, if you want to rob a bank on the first date, let's do it. Like, it's spontaneous and it's fun and we're doing it together. Okay. So what's like the most spontaneous thing they did and what would they want to do with it?
What's the most spontaneous thing that they've already done?
Yeah, they've already done.
So, and then what spontaneous thing they want to do with you?
Absolutely.
Contestant number one.
Oh, wow. Spontaneous. Well, I like to go out to the park, but I like to spice it up a little bit. And, sorry, I've been sitting too long.
So what's a spontaneous thing you would like to do with the possible date?
Oh, I'd take
them
to my factory, and we'd get some molds, we'd have some fun, create some things, play with some latex.
Whoa, didn't see that coming.
I feel like he's got something inside of him that he's just not letting out.
That's right. All right.
I can't wait to find out.
All right, so let's try and get some spontaneous from contestant number two. Something spontaneous on a date.
Well, the most spontaneous thing I've ever done is one time I had to burn down a room of my house because I had things in there.
Okay, that's all right.
What I would do spontaneous is on a date. I mean, really, the best thing to do is bring somebody for an experience they've never had before.
Sure.
So pick a table, make them disappear.
Sounds like he'd kill somebody.
He's mysterious.
Right. Okay, contestant number three.
The most spontaneous thing I ever did is I ran before they threw the ball.
I
think it is a spontaneous thing I'd do with you is we'd go find, I don't know, biggest mud puddle, and we'd roll around it and it's
I got dirty.
Second question.
Yes. Second cue. You know, Valentine's Day has always been a downer for me.
Sure.
It's been hard out there. So what would they do for me on a Valentine's
Day? All right, contestant number two, you're up first. What would you do for him on a Valentine's Day?
I mean, real simple. I bring you to the fanciest restaurant in the city. Sit wherever we want. Give you diamonds. Sure, maybe they're blood diamonds. Who knows?
All right, contestant number three.
Well, it would start out by sniffing each other's butts, and then we'd share a plate of spaghetti with one long noodle that would connect us in the middle, and we definitely would not have chocolate.
You know, I know you love puppies, but I'm beginning to like this puppy.
I know, this is a good boy.
Justin, number one.
Oh, I'm a big fan of sword fighting. I love sword fighting. We just, you know, hit each other, play a little bit, experiment.
All right, happy Valentine's Day for that, huh?
Don't have to read between those lines.
Bold writing.
Oof. You know, I'm really nervous about this last one.
Sure,
Do you mind?
Oh, you want to call a friend?
I want to call one of my friends in the audience. I want to ask about the bedroom, but I don't know what to ask. Fetishes.
So I thought she said finishes. I was like, whoa.
That's one of my fish. That's one of my
fish. Oh, that's one of your fish?
That's
oh,
one of the salmon.
Oh,
hey, how are you? Gobble, gobble.
Oh, you're that's from Alaska. Welcome to Savannah.
Good to see you. That's her husband, the swordfish.
All right. So what's the question?
Oh, the question is, I'm really sorry. I got sidetracked. So what is your deepest, darkest fetish in the bedroom?
Deepest, darkest fetish, contestant three.
My deepest, darkest fetish in the bedroom. Well, I like to lick you all over with my really long tongue, but I also have a thing for eating my own poop.
All right. You know what? I'm going to give her points for being bold.
Yeah, but bold. Yeah, bold. It was okay. Going really well.
All right, contestant one.
I'm sorry, can you repeat the question, please?
What fetishes would you bring to the bedroom?
Wow, this is my topic right here. You know, the bigger, the better. You know, I want you to just really give it to me, you know, ram it really hard, just right in my intestine, just get it in there.
Okay, we're gonna, okay.
Sounds like him and the other one should get together.
Yeah. I don't know, yeah, fetishes, okay, yeah, there we go. Yeah, fetishes number two.
Well, you know, being bound, yeah, you know, like water beds, anything really involving fishes and sleeping with them. you know, just finding ways to bring in the gang and have a good time.
All right. He likes fish too.
And a gang.
That's right. A school of fish for you, a gang of fish for
him. All right.
Are you ready to pick?
I can't possibly.
All right, we're going to have to go to you guys.
I can't possibly.
All right, based on round of applause, we're going to go through all three. When I put my hand over the head, you decide on who he's going on a date with. Here we go, the puppy. The accountant. The dildo. The puppy!
I'm out of here.
All right. Soundproof booth that's also outside that door.
Yeah, go for it.
So, friends, what we need from you guys, this is a guessing game. Bree and I are going to do some improv up here. He's going to join our scene without knowing a couple things.
Okay.
From you guys, I need a place that fits on stage. For example, ones we've gotten recently, Foxy Loxy Coffee Shop Closet. We've also gotten the attic and a Starbucks. We like coffee here at Savannah. So, from you guys, what's a place that could fit on stage?
The lumber department at Lowe's.
The lumber department at Lowe's.
So if Matt gets close to that, if he says one of those words.
You guys go like this.
Yeah, yep.
Right, if he says
lumber, you guys go ahead and snap.
Yeah.
That means he's close. If he says the lumber department, still just keep snapping because we need him to say.
Keep snapping.
We need him to say the lumber department at Lowe's, and then you lose your shit. Lumber department at Lowe's. All right, that's the first one. Second one. What is an object that you would not find at Lowe's at all? An unrelated object, completely.
Belly button lid.
Belly button lid. Okay. Look, you guys holding it down.
Okay, so lumber department at Lowe's.
Yep.
Belly button.
Danger, you're writing these down. Yep. Belly button lint.
Belly button lint.
If he says lint, you guys, snap, snap, snap. If he says lint, snap, snap, snap. That's right.
And he says tummy lint. First of all, gross.
All right, so we got that. And then the third one. What is a phrase that might become from your household or your family? For example, growing up, when I was in high school and I'm leaving the house, my dad would say, use your head. That was our family phrase.
It is what it is.
All right, okay. So we got to get into all three of those things. We're going to need your help throughout it. Let's watch him suffer. Can we get started with a round of applause?
I need like a 2x4, I need a 2x6, I need a 2x8.
Oh, sorry, I'm late, guys. Sorry, I'm late.
It's okay. It's okay.
Hey, grab the other end.
We got a big one.
I'd love to grab the other end.
Not the small one, the bigger one.
The smaller one.
Come on, Clark. Get your head out of your ass.
I am sorry, jabroni.
Yeah. Listen. They need some plywood. Right. They want some cherries.
I had my last day at Home Depot. Last day.
Fuck Home Depot.
Oh, wow. Yeah, fuck them. That's why I quit.
Yeah.
Listen, calm down.
Sorry.
We wished them well, but we're better. You know?
Yeah,
better.
Lowe's.
Yeah.
Lowe's. Blue vests.
Yeah, exactly. But some of the departments are lame. I want them to be the lighting department.
Electric suck.
Yeah. Ben
suck.
Franklin, eat it.
Yeah, suck it.
Yeah.
Suck it.
I love this department.
Yeah, wood.
That's true.
I like where
lumber.
Yeah.
I love being a lumberman.
Yeah.
The lumber department at Lowe's.
Yeah.
I fear you guys.
Whoa. Look at little itchy John over there.
Oh, no. Sorry.
No,
yeah.
I can see it.
There's no hot water in my house. I'm a bitch with cold water. I can't shower.
We got lice?
No, I don't got lice.
I don't know.
No, I don't.
I saw you this weekend. You were wearing sweaters.
I was. It got cold here in Savannah. It was like 50 degrees.
Hey, I love a good sweater.
You know what happens when you wear sweaters?
You get that wool bite.
Yeah, you get that.
It gets all over my body.
Yeah. Oh, yeah. You get all cashmere. You're like a dope.
Yeah. You know what? Let me just take care of that.
Get some of that off.
Oh,
here.
Yeah. Get a lint roller for us.
Yes.
But not just any lint roller, I bet.
Well, it's not so much what she's doing, but what she's getting off.
Who
wants to make a wish?
A belly button wish.
Yes,
you're getting that belly button wish.
Yeah. All right, go ahead and make a wish.
Fuck electric.
Yeah.
Wish came true.
Yeah, they were born fucked.
Guys, I've been reading Stephen King's entire catalog.
The whole thing?
Harry.
Misery.
The axe one.
Yeah, that's misery.
Shawshank Redemption.
Yeah,
I read a book.
Yeah, but I like the dark stuff, you know?
Ooh, yeah. I love those
things. And I love it when it gets made into movies.
The Mist.
Yeah, The Mist, that's right. That's right, but it's nothing scary.
Or like a good horror one.
Yeah.
Ooh, yeah.
Scary as a clown.
In the sewers, yeah.
Oh, it.
Yeah.
Yes.
It's a good one.
Yeah.
It's great.
It is a good one.
I love it. Ba-da-ba-ba-ba. I'm loving it.
is a saying.
You know, I had no words when I watched that movie.
No,
I
was speechless.
It wasn't quite speechless. I had some words, I guess. I had some words. I mean, I walked out of that movie, and, you know, I said the title that you just said. I said,
It's always happening to me.
Yeah, close.
It's a four!
No, you're more vague. But because I was like, you know, that was so good. You know,
it's.
Oh, no, say each word.
Guys, a reporter just called me. Yeah. A reporter just called me, and he asked for who,
where, why.
Yeah, one of them.
Wait, so way down.
Who, where.
What, where, why?
Yeah.
No.
Why, Stella?
No. He just wanted
who, where.
When?
No!
What is the matter with
stuff? Hey, you know, electric, those light bulbs have 1,000
watts.
Yeah!
What?
That's it.
Yeah, and what?
Okay. So back to the movie.
Yeah, you know, great film.
Yeah. You know, you walk out of there and you say the title.
Chill
it,
Georgie.
Say the title.
It is.
And now go back to the electric department when you
What? What is it?
No, start over.
What it is?
No.
It is what it is.
Good job, Dad. Guys, we are going to take a 10-minute break. Grab a drink. Use the bathroom. Oh, yes. And before you go, don't get up yet. For the second half of the show, we are going to use your New Year's resolutions to help us with our scene work. So we're going to put out some paper. We're going to put out some pens, and if you could write down your resolution, put it in there. We'd love for you. We know you're going to lose weight, and we know you're going to have sex with your husband. Other than that, like some unusual...
We're all going to have sex with your husband.
Line up, Johnny. But if you guys could put some unusual or fun ones, but they should still be true, right?
Yes, I do.
Keep them true, but just, you know, some of the odder ones, right?
Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah. I think that's right.
Like, I'm going to not eat blue cheese for a
month. Yeah, like something more specific.
It is what it is.
It is what it is, you know? Right. Awesome, put them in there. If you're on Zoom, please type them in. New Year's resolutions, we're back in 10.
Thank you.
Darkest New Year's resolutions, and I hope they all come through before we even start reading.
for this one. I need everybody. I need all you motherfuckers. Get on up here. Now, before we start, we have a big thank you to some of the people who helped make tonight happen. We got Ellen on the keys. Yeah. Danger up in the booth. Yeah. You had Heidi and Ellen on the door.
Yeah.
And you've got Dan on the bar.
Yeah.
Thank you to all of them, and thank you to all of you. Now, we're each going to read off one of these lovely resolutions, and we're going to use them to create a little set for you, a little play, a little something, something. So to start it out, Deshaun, read me a resolution.
Ooh, you got two there.
Watch less porn.
I don't see it happening, but good for you.
That's right. I decided not to be a jerk.
Aww. It's not a jerk if you watch porn.
Oh, no, that's what I do when I watch.
That was a pun. That was a very punny.
I drifted to porn land. I just didn't focus on anything else. Johnny Baby. What's your resolution, John?
Learn tap dancing.
Okay,
Charlotte.
John,
have
you ever tapped
him? I have, twice. But I've not really.
Like two taps?
I have tap shoes on and I walked around in them.
Okay, good.
Is anyone on stage? Are they a tap dancer?
Like as a kid.
Sure. Yeah. Okay, who's professional?
All right, we got give up porn, learn the tap dance, or watch less porn, not give it up.
Yeah. Eat more pomegranate.
Oh.
Have you had pomegranate before?
I've actually never had a pomegranate.
It's all about
somebody get a pomegranate.
Sorry.
I was gifted a pomegranate last week.
Somebody gave you a pomegranate?
Someone gave us a, Dan's mom gave us a pomegranate.
Yeah. What does it taste like?
I haven't used a present.
Wait, last week that pomegranate is turning real soon.
Probably. I didn't know what to do with it.
It's all about the seeds.
Yeah, I guess eat it.
Give it to whoever had the resolution.
I needed the YouTube. I should have watched the YouTube.
Yeah. Yeah. What did you say about pomegranate?
It's probably about the turn.
That's probably about the turn. Oh, okay.
Yeah.
What did you do?
I can understand what you said. That's what
I was
saying. Ladies and gentlemen, next. Resolution. Heidi, what are you going to be doing in the new year?
Go to the gym 7 days a week.
Wow. Wow.
That's a lot.
Seven days.
That's a long year.
That's every day.
Yeah. That is literally all the days.
It's almost 365, baby. All right.
Three.
To market my business better.
That's good.
No, I like that. Career oriented. I feel like a woman.
If you open up a pomegranate-based gym, you're going to have some great
luck. I know.
And the final resolution. Go on more walks. But what I like about this person, they started to say something else.
Yeah.
And they were like, nah, fuck that. I'm not going to accomplish that. So I'm going to say walk more.
Yes.
I wonder what that first one was something. It was something good. It was like
my,
I don't know. Well, go on more walks. Very nice. Oh, we have quite a bit more. Do we want to pocket some?
Yes.
So what we're going to do is we're just going to take a couple of these, put them in our pockets, and we're going to use these.
Don't look at them.
That makes me happy. All right, perfect. I'm not gonna have any. Okay.
Here, take one of mine.
I'll take one of yours. Okay. All right, perfect. Ladies and gentlemen, we are gonna do a series of scenes for you to get us started. Can you please give us a little shimmy, shimmy, sham on the hand? Hey, Tammy, Happy New Year.
Hey, Ron.
Oh, man.
Jeez, man, I got hammered last night.
Oh, yeah, you go out?
I hit the town and I hit it hard.
Wow.
I didn't even remember what I wore.
Damn, Tammy. Yeah. Tammy, you're a legend, Tammy. Man,
you had a good night last night?
I hit it hard too, but I was by myself. I did my last, pounding of the new year, you know what I'm saying?
Pounding of the new year?
I'm giving up porn, Tammy.
Ron.
I haven't jerked off in 12 minutes.
Disgusting, Ron. 12 minutes.
I lapsed already, all right, Tammy. It was a good
boardroom meeting in the morning.
It's January.
Yeah, second. I know. Don't jump ahead of July. God, I'm going to be so backed up.
Ron, I remember last year when you gave up porn, what it did to you.
Yeah,
remember those 2 days? Oh, do you remember those 2 days?
I was so efficient, it was disgusting.
It was.
God, the numbers were never better.
You were polite.
I was nice.
God. Ron.
What?
I just sent an email to HR.
About the...
That you just...
Come on.
That you jerked off 12 minutes ago.
What the fuck, Tammy?
HR knows, Ron.
Well, I'm going to tell HR that you were out there on River Street potentially bringing a virus into the fucking workplace.
Listen, having chlamydia is normal.
Oh, no, it's not. That's what you said last year when you were like, this year I'm not getting gonorrhea. So what, you got chlamydia? That's way better. Fuck you, Tammy.
You know what?
You know what? I'm going to jerk off later, and I'm going to be thinking about you. How about that? Wow.
Whoa!
I didn't mean to say it. Don't tell HR.
I'm telling HR.
Don't tell HR.
Oh, sorry. I didn't mean to bother you between classes.
No, it's okay, Timmy. You're not bothering me.
Okay. What do you got there? You see, is that a pomegranate?
Yeah. My friend gave it to me. It's been in my locker for about a week.
Your friend? I know there was an anonymous note with it. Yeah.
They said, be more flexible.
Yeah.
I didn't really know how to take that when they handed me the pomegranate. I've never even eaten a pomegranate before.
You've never eaten a pomegranate?
I've never had one.
Connor, it's going to turn.
It's already started to turn.
Well, you gotta cut it off at the past. Take a big spoke of shit.
How are you kidding? I've had it in school. What do you think this is, Munch Corner?
Oh, that's a good looking pomegranate. Subscribe it, Connor.
Oh, this pomegranate is moldy. Juicy, it's got seeds in it. I think you should have the best
bite. Whoa. You wanted to take it.
I didn't want to take it.
I saw you. It chose you.
Do you guys hear?
Oh!
There are moldy pomegranates all over school.
What? What?
It's an invasion of the moldy pomegranate.
I knew this would happen. God, why did I do that curse to the moon?
Oh, guys, just be careful. Whatever you do, you don't want to eat one.
Connor, did you take a bite of it?
I didn't, but it said be more flexible.
I'm taking a bite of it.
Wait,
because the book that I read says you become something more. Eat more pomegranate.
Up?
How are you doing?
I'm a little sore. How are you doing?
Doing good. I'm just getting ready for my New Year's resolution. You know, I'm going to go to the gym a little bit more. I just even out the rest of the body. I got this.
Yeah. I see that one arm is like jacked.
Real strong.
Do you do like the dumbbell bench press, not the barbell bench?
I definitely do something like that.
Yeah. I made a resolution to go to the gym all the time too. Because, you know, this is not going to get buffed. For the ladies.
Maybe we should be going to the gym together, you know what I'm saying? High five!
Thank you. I think it's broken.
I'm sorry. This is the problem. This is the problem. Every time I try to just do anything normal, I just crush everything.
I mean, you're so right-handed, it's ridiculous. Like, every now and again, use the left. Can you, like, high-five me with that one? Come on, you can do it. Oh, gosh. Try it again. Okay, we gotta work on that. We gotta bilaterally, unilaterally work your shit and your stuff and your gluteus and your things,
You guys, like, want, like, a towel or anything? You're gonna go in?
Oh, inside the gym. We gotta go there.
Well, I'm not afraid of the gym. I'll walk right in there.
A lot
of people sign up, man, on like the first, and like I just want to let you know right now, like, if you cancel, I'm not gonna be a dick about it. Like, a lot of people are dicks about it. I'm not gonna be a dick about it.
I really appreciate that, dude, because I'm feeling trepidatious about going in and they're
it's not for everyone.
Feeling, yeah.
I'll sign. Clearly. I'll sign right now.
Try it with your left hand.
I'm right-handed. It just makes sense.
You want to sign? We have like, if you sign with your left hand, you get free passes for a year. No, he has to sign on his own, man.
Oh man, sorry, dude.
Oh, okay, I can sign. I can do it.
What the fuck?
Sorry.
You got it. I believe in you.
Can I use my mouth?
You're my role model.
They don't pay me enough not to. Oh, yeah.
So, ladies and gentlemen, you can write your name with your mouth, but not that stupid ass last one.
Hey, so I'm watching you. Nice.
Whoa, nice colt.
I'm here for a purpose, baker man.
Oh, here for breads and bakers?
You do have the finest bakery in town.
Yes, I do know how to sling some flour. Look at me sling it.
Whoa. Dynamite.
It's good slinging.
Your sourdough is impeccable.
Some people.
Your wheat is a delight.
Tell me about
and
the rye.
And your rye is like a rye bourbon. I sip it at night.
You know, I sell some of that on the side, so Montague, if you ever want. Anyway, I noticed you slew another dragon. Thank you.
Oh, you heard about that?
Oh, they all.
Because not enough people have heard about that.
No.
I would like to market my business for
you. You want to market your dragon slaying business?
Of course. I would like to know if I could have my face on your sourdough.
I'll do you one better than that. You notice how I've had many, many customers lately coming in asking me for my good sourdough, my mountain rustic.
Mm-hmm. Yes, yes.
I opened up a GoDaddy.com domain.
Ooh! GoDaddy.com. I've heard about it. Don't know exactly what it is.
Oh, Danica Patrick does a great job selling it here.
Oh, I slay that dragon.
Oh, I tried one. She's very intense. Okay.
She's hard to catch.
She is hard to catch. Zoom, zoom. Holy shit, motherfucker! It's a dragon!
Dragon!
Wait a minute! Don't just slay it. That's your problem.
Wait a minute. That's my problem. You're not critiquing me on my business?
Do a TikTok with it first and then.
Give me all of your sourdough!
Oh, no, it's gonna eat me.
Hey, what's up? It's me, old sir.
Sir Montague.
There's my good friend, Dragon. I'm going to play with my food first.
Fuck! Motherfucker! Sir Montague!
The blood! The blood!
I've got places to be!
My dragon leg!
Sir Montague!
I'm flying! Hold on! I just posted it on TikTok! The likes are coming in!
Sir Montague.
Yes?
I've always had something to say. You dragons should hear this too. To get this fucker to propose to me.
I had no idea.
Look at you, dragon.
Not today, Sir Montague. Not today.
And when?
Hey, are you ready to walk the fuck out of this mall?
Oh, you know it. I've been practicing that power walk.
Yeah, look at a power walk. Listen, I heard that you went on a new date with that new guy and that new place.
Well, you know, I don't like to kiss and tell. But let me tell you what happened.
Let's do a long walk.
Can I spray you with this perfume?
Oh, please. Oh. It's so cheap. So tell me about your date.
Rachel Twister.
Oh, just a sample, right?
Yeah, throw it.
So did you get first base, second base? What did you get?
We got deep into fifth base.
Woo!
Adopt this orphan. Adopt this orphan.
Hey, kids.
No. Oh, look at Dom.
It's just a random.
That date I went on.
Yeah, the fifth base one?
That's right. He's too good of a man to go without somebody. Take my place.
You want me to take him for you?
Take him for you. Yeah, yeah. It's
hey,
middle of the night.
I'm Tiffany. Do you know my friend Veronica, the one that you went on a date with last week?
Yeah, I heard she was in the hospital. Is she doing okay?
No, she's dead.
God.
Yeah.
Sorry.
So
what?
So do you want to have me? Do you want to do a switcheroo is what I'm trying to say. You know, back in the olden days, like when...
Is she at her funeral yet?
No.
Oh, no? Well, you know, I mean... Have you?
Have I what?
You seem fit.
Oh, thanks. I like to work out okay, 7 days a week. Aww. You seem pretty trim yourself.
Oh, thanks. I've been eating more.
Yeah, I heard that you went to Fifth Base.
Fifth Base? She told you about Fifth Base?
She did.
Oh,
are you ready for an upgrade?
Then to stand on the corner and like wave that sign around for Geico, we'd have to do all this shit.
It's so tiring.
I mean, I'm ready. Look, hold the sign.
Did I say stop tap dancing? No, sir, you didn't.
Okay, there's never left.
Open. Cindy.
Did I say stop?
No, you didn't. This isn't what I really wanted to do this year. I had a different dream. I wanted to drink more beer.
I'm gonna need more after all this talking.
Ew, Mom, it's homeless people.
Oh my God,
homeless.
Don't look. Oh God, we don't want your insurance.
We're not homeless.
I'd rather they think I'm an alcoholic.
Hey, welcome to Jeremy's Pub. What do you want?
I want your biggest, tallest beer.
Nah, I can't do that, man. We're all White Claw now. White Claw, truly, even got some high noons.
Everyone's switching over to seltzer now.
Yeah, man, it was our resolution last year, but nobody showed up.
But my resolution, I wanted to drink more beer.
It sucks, man.
Hey, is this saloon open?
Hey, partner.
You got any White Claw on tap? I want a good raspberry.
Oh, I got double ras.
Easy there, string bean.
You're drinking White Claws.
Of course I'm drinking White Claw. I'm a man.
Yeah, he's a man. What are you?
Any of you men who drink White Claw want to come up with a whore? Because my New Year's resolution was take a multivitamin every day, and by multivitamin, I mean lots of dick.
Yeah.
I'll take two.
Hold the White Claw.
Get up there, partner.
Well, I'll leave you with this.
Tell me something.
I'll tell you, whenever I go upstairs with a whore that's eager beaver, I always like to tell my friends, not have a baby, I get pregnant. I don't say it clearly.
You want to read that to me again there, partner?
Sure, I'm going
to
say it the exact way I always say it.
Yeah, tell me about
not it. Have a baby, I get pregnant. My father. So I don't have a baby because if I have a baby, then I get pregnant.
Then you get pregnant.
You know,
I get it. That's the real old restless.
Most people think it works in reverse. It doesn't.
Nope.
Don't have the baby, then you'll get pregnant. That's how it goes right there.
Yeah. That was a
Thompson freeze.
Hi. It's Billy from accounting.
Yeah.
You saw my email about the guy who jerks off to me?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Sit down.
Thanks. Do you want to come hear about it?
Oh, he's just
I'm just watching.
Okay. He's an intern. I hope you don't mind.
I'm just here to make sure you have a female representation.
Thank you. So anyway, I was sitting next to Ron.
I'm also here. I have not decided what gender I am yet.
And I'm hiding over here, not doing anything.
That's Ron. That's the guy.
I gave it up, damn it, Jesus Christ!
He said it was 9:54. We were at our desks. We've been working since 9 o'clock.
Okay.
And he announced to the room that he hadn't jerked off in 12 minutes. Then he proceeded.
I'm sorry, is that a normal amount of that? 12 minutes? I just want to know like how often people jerk off.
I mean, we'd have to consult Ron for that because I don't know about that part of it. But
Should we bring Ron in here?
If you want.
Would that make you uncomfortable?
It would absolutely make
me
uncomfortable.
Okay, Ron, go ahead. Come in here, please.
Yeah. I never left.
Ron, you didn't jerk. You told the room that you didn't jerk off in 12 minutes.
Yeah, I told you.
Yeah.
Well, that's not telling the room. That's just coworker.
And when I looked at his computer, he had an email open, and it said he wanted to poop more. He wanted to poop more.
Thank you.
Are you running this down?
Yeah. I want to keep good. I want to be regular.
Yeah.
You know what I mean?
It's good. He's being honest. It's a new year.
Thank you. Thank you, HR.
As a representation of her, let's not take away from her focus. This is her meeting.
Thank you.
And you're welcome.
Yeah.
Hey, can I get some interns?
Interns? Yeah. We are gender representation.
Well, that guy, he said.
I mean, I am an intern. Hey. But gender representation.
And I'm just here because I want a threesome.
This is really making my resolution difficult.
Right.
I want to file a complaint about that.
At 9:46, he proceeded to shut my computer down.
Okay.
And then he announced to the room that he pictures me when he masturbates.
Now, when he was saying this, I just wanted to make sure he didn't say anything like, eat less meat or anything like that.
No, I never told him to eat less meat.
Oh, great.
I never said that. I would never tell you that.
No, I confirm that
that's an improvement.
That is an improvement on me.
So that just means that you're not going down on anybody. Is that correct? No oral for you? Is that correct?
No oral for me?
You're eating less
HR.
Meat.
So HR!
Is he going to
take command of the room?
You're right. This is ridiculous. John, I think you should leave. I think that maybe you shouldn't be fondling them over there. Your meeting is next. So it's 9:56.
At 9:56, I started to walk out of the room. He tackled me.
He tackled you?
He lifted up my shirt and he gave me a raspberry.
He gave you a raspberry.
Yes.
Is your belly button lint still there?
It's not any longer.
Did he make a wish?
I don't know if you've noticed, but like all of these guys, they're just like, you're going to the gym and getting all buff. It's gross.
Hey, that's their prerogative.
It's all veiny.
Yeah. I mean, yeah.
And they can like lift.
Have you ever done a push-up?
Why would I ever touch the ground?
I've done a push-up.
You've done a push-up? Oh my god!
Sorry,
oh my
just god. Trying to get to the workout equipment. Really need to work out the other limbs.
This is what I'm talking about. Like,
excuse me, it's going to take me a while. Just one arm.
Is this hot piece of slug ass?
Well, like half of them.
I have legs that just are not worked out,
oh my
ladies.
God, it is a wordsmith.
You don't have to work out. You don't need to. Oh, come on.
Do you think he's single? Are you looking to mingle?
Yes.
I'm looking to mingle. Give me a second. Oh my. Oh wow.
Oh,
he's so independent. Whoa, what's up? How are you doing?
I'm doing pretty good.
Hold on, sidebar for a second. Like, I think like half of him is like really for you, and the other half is like really.
But now you want in on this shit?
I want
now you want in on this shit?
I want like the weak.
Don't worry, here comes a slug boy now. For you.
Oh, another one?
Yeah.
Oh my god, like on command.
Yeah, that's how they work.
Hi, slug boy.
Oh. Hey, Tim.
Oh god, they know each other. We can double easily. Here, hop
we
up
can
on
double
here.
Date.
We can double date. You talk to your
don't
guy.
Help him.
You talk to your guy.
So, do I know you from like karaoke at McDonald's?
Well,
what karaoke song do you like to sing?
I like to sing the opening theme song to that anime, One Punch Man.
Oh yeah? Can I hear a bar?
So like, I carry these.
It's in Japanese. You wouldn't understand it.
Come on, I want to hear a bar.
It's in Japanese.
Come on, I want to hear a bar. Oh, he's so talented.
One punch man! Oh. One punch!
And then there's like a lot of Japanese.
I like want to see that show right now.
So like pomegranate seeds are really good for your like souls?
Yes.
Like your salty feet.
I feel like I'm sluggier because of them.
That makes me so fucking horny.
What is your name again?
My name's Pinnell.
Pinnell? I'm a P.
Nancy! Guys, thank you for your New Year's resolution!
Come to God, they all come true. Ladies and gentlemen, we have had so much goddamn fun with you guys and with you on Zoom. Please give yourselves a round of applause. It's been a blast. New Year has officially begun, and we are off and running here, ladies and gentlemen. Front Porch Improv, check out the website. We offer classes, I believe, level 1 and 2.
Have new adult classes starting in 2 weeks, and then we have kids, elementary, middle, and high school classes starting in 3 weeks.
Absolutely. Yeah. It's going to be a lot of fun, and just keep up with everything. Check out Patreon if you're interested, and but really, it's such a pleasure to have you guys, especially you're out of town. Thank you very much. Hope to see you guys again. Our locals, yeah. See you someplace. Yes. Great to have you guys.
Thank you.
What we are gonna do now is we're gonna put up the house lights, play a little music, but we are not kicking you guys out. Feel free to finish your drinks, hang tight, whatever you gotta do. And it's been a lot of fun. We'll see you someplace.